there's an age-old question among the student body of Brownsburg High School. One that seems to pit friend against friend, student against student, and department against department. One that doesn't seem to have a definite answer. Is show choir a sport or not?
Against our better judgment, Chase and I decided to investigate. In our defense, we've had worse ideas. We were determined to find a true, definite, irrefutable answer, even though the question is kind of subjective.
Almost 3 months later, after hours of rehearsal, competition, and one-on-one interviews, the conclusion we reached was nothing like we were expecting. But before all that, on a January afternoon, Kellen and I sat in on Spotlight's rehearsal.
This may not go well, but let's just do it.
Right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, I'm Megan Carr, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Henry Hartley, and I'm a junior this year.
I'm Julia Comer, and I'm a senior.
My confidence is leaving. Beat on my own. That's where I need some anger. Like, right now, I'm like, man, I don't know why. You guys seem to be.
Looks like we work hard a lot, but honestly, we all just goof around like 25-8. So it's not just stressful, it's actually a lot of fun, so yeah.
The first thing we noticed during the rehearsal was how involved the student leadership was in the process.
I feel like I always like all the parts they don't like. I like watching vocal grades because I get to see how they've grown since we started this year, and even since some of them have been freshmen, because I know how a lot of these people were before, and it's cool to see how they've grown and become more comfortable in this group, and now they use the gifts that they've been given to really shine.
Mm-hmm. So since I'm one of the dance captains of Spotlight, I just help clean the choreo, and I'm kind of on leadership, so like I help make sure that practices run smoothly and like make sure everyone's under control.
It was kind of off for me at first because I wasn't used to having to take all the charge. There are times when I am in charge of running the entire rehearsal from start to finish sometimes, and it's just kind of different because I went from kind of sitting and being a member and not really having to do anything, just kind of following what other people are doing, to actually having to come up with the things that everyone is doing and kind of take charge. So it's a little bit different, but I think I'm slowly getting used to it and getting better at it.
Another thing that stood out to us was the dynamic between the members of the choir and their director, Chad Strasser.
Because I want to make sure you're going to be comfortable. To an extent. I mean, like that is an honest answer. The look is a little bit more important than you being comfortable. Sorry.
No, it can be.
Yeah.
It has been this year. Last year he was a cranky pants, but this year he's actually nice. Like all of the time, consistently. Yeah.
I was like so hyped about it, and I was like, we're doing so well, and then he was like, it was terrible.
And do that much again from the beginning of the I Can See Clearly part. Girls, sound is swallowed. Everybody, rhythm is terrible. Fix that.
That's good. Is it like actually good though?
Yes.
I mean, that sounded so fake.
No, Chase,
are you doing it with them? Are you doing it with Starlight too?
We'll be there next Tuesday for them.
We went to a Starlight rehearsal the week before their first performance and saw how the stress was affecting everyone. The rehearsal ended 25 minutes late and the hallway was dead quiet. The only thing you could hear was the sounds of lockers opening and closing and the occasional sniffling. Needless to say, nobody was in the mood to be interviewed. Cabaret, their first public performance, was less than 2 days away.
We had a bit of an effort issue. People were just, we were low on morale and people weren't trying as hard as they could have, and then just did not end on a good note. But we're starting this rehearsal. It's a fresh start.
The thing we try to push in leadership when we're having a bad rehearsal is that we can achieve anything if we do it together. And normally bad rehearsals are happening because individual mistakes are being made. And so we as leadership try to push the fact that we're all in this together, we're all one unit, we're all one Starlight or all one Spotlight, and we do it together, and that's how we be successful.
With the cabaret performance less than a day away, both choirs were eager and optimistic at the start of Thursday's rehearsal.
Man, I want to die.
Spirits were high, to say the least.
If anything goes wrong, our fishnets are going to rip.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cabaret is kind of infamous for like when all the disasters happen, but that's why we have it, is just to like make sure we get them out of the way before we go to a competition. Because if the first time we performed at a competition, we would not score very well. So it's kind of just to get everything out of the way. So then we have a week to fix whatever we messed up.
The songs in both Starlight and Spotlight's show featured a wide variety of genres and styles, ranging from Macklemore to The Beatles to Avenged Sevenfold. This proved to be a challenge for the choirs, as it was unlike anything they'd done before.
You know, I mean, I think when you look at Brownsburg, you don't think of expecting us to do like a screamo type song. The reason why it's so stressful is because all of a sudden it hits them, they have to do their show. And honestly, the week of your first competition, you make so much of an improvement and things start to fall together. When you're a week away from that, there's still a lot of things that are, you know, some costumes aren't totally finished yet. Or we're making tweaks to our arrangements. But the reason why cabaret is so helpful, it's stressful for them, but they get a performance under their belt, and then they still have a week to clean it up from there. Mm-hmm. It kind of gets all those pre-show jitters out, and then we've got a week to clean it up. And to think about taking 200 people to New York, it was, I mean, even when we got there on Friday, the first thing I said was, what was I thinking?
Near the end of February, and a first for the department, both Spotlight and Starlight made the trip to the Big Apple, New York City, to compete in the Hearts of America competition.
Here, Spotlight won first runner-up in the mixed division, and Starlight was declared the grand champs in the unisex division. Competing and winning on a national level was, ironically, only the start to the choir's competitive season. At Northridge, Starlight won grand champion along with best vocals and best visuals. Spotlight was first runner-up and also won best visuals. Then, at school rival Avon's Vocal Invitational, both groups won best visuals and grand champions, keeping up Starlight's multi-year streak.
Before their season drew to a close, there is still one more competition, this one a little closer to home.
It's the third year we've had to completely start from scratch, just because the construction changes it every year. So most people, once you get a contest up and going, and especially our first year, we had 50 choirs. It was one of the five largest contests attended in the whole country. So you would have thought, like, we're set up for success from now on. We've got it made. We've got a process. All we have to do is just recreate it. But every year we've had to start from scratch.
The Bulldog Spectacular, BHS's very own show choir competition, is an allied effort, with students, parents, volunteers, and even other teachers helping run the event.
I love the chaos of it all, and just the different shows and all the different people and how it looks like utter chaos, but it's all this amazing performance that all comes together in the end.
The competition, being almost all day for 2 days, was exhausting for those running it. We checked in halfway through the second day to see how they were doing.
All right.
What would a DJ name his child?
Eric.
They were holding it together.
Thank you, Peter.
Bathroom's this way.
There's a word that anybody involved in a remotely competitive high school activity is all too familiar with. It's something that is both anticipated and dreaded. A five-letter word that means the culmination of weeks and months of hard work. State.
Chase and I made the drive to North Central High School and arrived about halfway through the day, just in time to see Starlight perform and to see the Unisex Awards ceremony. Expectations were high, especially when you consider Starlight's astounding season.
On top of the world, honestly. We feel really, really, really good. But we know that there's more that we can keep doing to be better and to get the state championship title that we're going to get next Saturday.
So you can imagine everyone's surprise when...
the fourth place trophy is awarded to Brownsburg Starlight!
Everyone was surprised, but accepting of the results. Mostly.
Their thing, but the awards, in the nicest way possible, that's not what I prefer. Let's just say that.
Is that?
Yes. It's definitely controversial. But I mean, did I say that? But I mean, ISMA is ISMA. We've done our best. We've gone undefeated. I tell you, we get.
So now the pressure was on for Spotlight to perform later in the day and take home the grand prize. Or was it?
Well, with every competition, Strasser always is like, just. If that was your best, then it doesn't even matter. So that's what I'm going with. That was our absolute best, and so it doesn't matter.
I feel happy that we had a nice last performance, and we all just really connected this year, and we all had a fun time together, and it doesn't really matter about the place anymore just because we've had so much fun.
Performing arts isn't like football or baseball. It's subjective. Winning and losing isn't based on a concrete score, it's based on an opinion. And if that's the case, does winning even matter? We were about to find out as we all shuffled in for the final award ceremony of the night. At this point, we just accepted that show choir kids never ran out of energy.
Everyone, at some point in their life, experiences free fall. It's a moment where the fate of everything you've worked for, even for just a millisecond, is completely out of your control. For show choir, that moment is spent in a crowded gymnasium, waiting to hear your name get called.
That brings us back to the original question, the one we asked all those months ago. Is show choir a sport or not?
And the truth is, it feels a little stupid to even ask that question.
Yeah, we realize that's a bit of a cop-out, but when you factor in everything that we've seen, the highs, the lows, the triumphs, the defeats, the friends made, and the memories shared, does it matter if it's a sport or not? Who cares if it is or isn't? We saw a group of people that loved what they did and loved the people they did it with. Isn't that the most important thing?
At the end of the day, we think they said it better than we ever could.
I want them to feel like all the effort they put into it was worth it, and I hope they learned something from it that they can continue with for the rest of their life. Show choir is not going to be their profession, but they learn a lot from it that's going to help them after they're done with it.
I know how a lot of these people were before, and it's cool to see how they've grown and become more comfortable in this group, and now they use the gifts that they've been given to really shine.
Every day I find something to appreciate, and I just sing about when I'm having a bad day, like see that all the people that have like changed me for the better, so I just think of them.
We've been searching for years. What is gonna be the identity of Brownsburg Show Choir? And it's hot. Because that's when we are at our best. You just put everything out there on stage, time and time again. And then when I think, gosh, what more can we do? We find another level the next year.
We can achieve anything if we do it together. We're all one unit, we're all one Starlight, or all one Spotlight, and we do it together, and that's how we be successful.
The show must go on!
smile still.